Today, we have filed charges of first-degree murder against Brian George Fitch.
Tonight, 12 charges filed against one man, the man accused of killing Officer Scott Patrick.
But we brought this person to justice.
Police officers angry and upset at the loss of one of their own.
The relentless efforts to find this cop killer.
And in St. Paul, a heartbreaking scene. A procession of peace officers escorting the body of Officer Scott Patrick to the funeral home where his life will be honored.
But first, with the dozen charges against him in two counties, Brian Fitch Sr. faces life in prison if convicted of murdering Officer Scott Patrick.
Fitch is charged with two counts of first-degree murder in Dakota County, where Officer Patrick was killed in West St. Paul. And then in Ramsey County, he's charged with 10 different counts, including three attempted murder charges for allegedly firing on officers. Our Josh Rosenthal is live in West St. Paul tonight with more insight into what happened the day Officer Patrick was shot. Josh?
Yeah, Tom, we now have a much better idea of what happened Wednesday before and after Officer Scott Patrick was shot. That includes some chilling comments from Brian Fitch.
Today we have filed charges of first-degree murder.
And that's just the beginning. Altogether, Brian Fitch faces 12 charges in the killing of Mendota Heights Officer Scott Patrick.
You could not find a better role model. He will be greatly missed.
According to criminal complaints, Fitch shot Patrick in the leg, abdomen, and head. Then a witness grabbed Patrick's radio and said, "Officer, down." From there, the manhunt was on.
This defendant has a history of violence, hatred toward police officers, and was going to do anything, including murder, to evade capture.
Prosecutors say Fitch switched cars, borrowing a new one from someone he knew. They say ultimately two confidential informants led police to Fitch. Three people were in the vehicle at first, according to the reports. One jumped out, then the shootout started. According to one officer, Fitch made no signs of wanting to give up or surrender. He was ducking down and coming up repeatedly while he was firing.
This tragedy, as John indicated, is a reminder to all of us just how dangerous being a law enforcement officer is.
In the end, once Fitch was shot, captured, and taken to the hospital, criminal complaints say a police officer stood over him and Fitch said, "Just to let you know, I hate cops and I'm guilty." Prosecutors wouldn't say if they expect anyone else to be charged in this case. We do expect the two other people who were in the car with Fitch to be okay. I'll be back at 6 with more, including the unusual legal strategy that prosecutors plan to implement in this case. Reporting live in West St. Paul, Josh Rosenthal, 5 Eyewitness News.
Okay, Josh, today a heartbroken family has set the funeral arrangements for Officer Patrick. This was the scene in St. Paul just a few hours ago as peace officers escorted the remains of Officer Patrick to the funeral home where he'll be remembered. A visitation will be held next Tuesday from 2 to 8 at St. Stephen's Lutheran Church in West St. Paul. The funeral will be held the next day at church at 11 o'clock. As many as 3,000 police officers are expected to attend Officer Patrick's funeral.
Here's a look at